Hello Internet, I'm Guy. Recently I was watching this video by Artisan Makes about some problems he had with his lathe and some improvements he was working on, and he mentioned making a drivable chuck key that you could put into a cordless drill to drive the jaws of your chuck open and closed quickly. So I've decided to make a double ender for my two different chuck keys. So I'm going to start out by measuring the outside diameter of the key insert part right here, and just wiggle that around in the jaws of my caliper, and I've got 0.295 inches on that one. That's my four jaw chuck key. And now I'll check the three jaw chuck key, and that looks about 0.389. Let's call it 390. Write that down. And then I need to know the length here, so I'm going to measure that. Not that end, silly, this end. Okay. 0.463, call it 0.45 maybe. And maybe the other one is about the same. Yeah, that's going to be close enough. 0.45 should get good penetration in there. Make a note of that. So over to the lathe, I'm going to take a piece of that half inch stock that I had there, noticing that I could really use a drill driver to crank that thing closed because it's tedious. Now I'm going to start off by just taking this material down. I've set an end stock for my carriage, and I have a motorized carriage here, so when I engage the motor, it'll go to the stop point and then automatically shut off the motor that moves the carriage. So then I can just reverse the switch and drive it back out again. This is a feature that I really enjoy on my machine that was a really great improvement for my needs. I'll link to that video below. So just going back and forth, of course, reducing thickness and so forth, get it down to where I need it. Multiple passes. Okay, I'm going to take that out of the chuck, flip it around, and then turn the small diameter at the end of this end for the four-jaw chuck, which is a smaller key, if you will. So I'm just going to flatten off the end, as is tradition. Start turning it down here. Lots of lube. Same thing, I've set my end stop so that it stops just where I want it. And keep on going down here. I really like my motorized carriage. You know, I don't do thread cutting on my lathe. I do that with taps and dies. And so just being able to drive the carriage back and forth is just a really pleasant feature. So I'm coming in here with a lathe file and just smoothing it out a little bit, just because I like nice shiny surfaces, even though a lot of that's going to be cut off. I'm just beveling these edges, making it a little nicer, a little friendlier. So I'd already done the other end, and now I'm just bringing in the lathe file to clean up the exterior surface there, the original mill finish, and a little bit of 440 paper to clean that up some more, just to make it shiny. So now I'm going to start machining off the flats on the milling machine, and you can see I have a collet mounted to a square block that I can rotate in 90 degree increments. Quick sanity check after doing two surfaces there, and that looks good. So I'm going to take a little bit off here, another 5 thou, to get that all trued up, squared up. And on to the next one now. This is the bigger one, so I'm going to speed this up a little bit because it's tedious, but you get the idea. So now, I had a little bit of a lapse of attention and cut too deep on that one. So a bit of a do-over. So I did it over again, and now it's a little bit snug. It goes in that way, but that way is too tight. So I'm back onto the machine and take a 2/1000 off all around. That works great. Okay, I'm pleased with that. So now here it is in a cordless drill, and yay! Oh my goodness, what a nice time saver. I love this. It's so cool. So here's my key in the four-jaw chuck, and again, this not in the cordless drill. I'm just going to twirl it by hand, but you get the idea. So there it is.